Dear Bald Engineer, hey, that's me. How would you like to get a free Raspberry Pi? It is a B+.
Pi.
Well, I think I'd like a free Pi, even if they consider it only a B+, because hey, free Pi is good. I think I'm going to go ahead and respond and ask them to send me one. So once it gets here, we can check it out. Alright, so I think this is the Raspberry Pi. Let's take a look. Well, not quite the kind of Pi I was expecting, but still a pretty good Pi to get in the mail. Alright, so we see the board, and it comes in the ESD bag, which is a nice touch. Back in AddOhms number 7, we looked at the Raspberry Pi and compared it to another popular board. So I won't cover the basics in this video, but you can go check out that one if you don't know what a Raspberry Pi is. Let's look at what is new about the B+. First thing to know is that the onboard power is provided by switching regulators, which means about 150 milliamps of less current being used. The SD slot on the bottom has been replaced by a micro SD slot. So you'll need to grab one of these if you don't have one already. There are more GPIO pins available. The good thing is the pinout is backwards compatible with the previous Pis, so your existing accessories should work just fine. There are now 4 USB ports which can handle up to 1.2 amps of current, which means no more hubs, yay! The analog and video port are now combined into a commonly available 4-pin connector that looks kinda like a headphone jack. And lastly, note that the B+ has a new layout for the 4 mounting holes. The Raspberry Pi B+ is a pretty cool little board. You get the power of a PC in a credit card size board, and it's only 35 bucks. So whether you already have an existing Pi, or you're new to the world of Raspberry Pi, it's easy to add to any electronics kit. If you have any questions about the Pi or the B+, feel free to leave a comment. I'd also like to hear from you on what projects you're going to use your Raspberry Pi for. In the meantime, I'm going to take a bite out of mine. Really good.